Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kandan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 33 and the topic is Problems in the Rocket Propulsion. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the working of different rocket engine and we discussed the theory of the rocket propulsion. And we discuss the performance parameters of the rocket propulsion like thrust to produce, specific impulse, propulsive efficiency, thermal efficiency and overall efficiency. And in this lecture, we will be solving problem in the rocket propulsion. The problems are taken from the Anna University question paper and the learning outcome to the students. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in rocket propulsion. Example number one. A rocket has the following data. The propellant flow rate is 5 kilograms per second. Nozzle exit diameter 10 centimeter. Nozzle exit pressure 1.02 bar. Ambient pressure 1.013 bar. Thrust chamber pressure 20 bar. Thrust to produce is 7 kN. Determine the effective jet velocity, actual jet velocity, specific impulse and the specific propellant consumption. So, this question is from November 2003, November 2009, May 2010 and November 2013. So, we write down the given data. The mass of the propellant MP equal to 5 kilograms per second. Diameter of the nozzle D equal to 0.1 meter. Exit pressure of the nozzle is PE equal to 1.02 bar. Atmospheric pressure is PA equal to 1.013 bar. And the thrust produced F equal to 7 kN. The effective jet velocity CJ equal to thrust produced divided by the propellant flow rate. So, F divided by MP. So, substituting CJ equal to 7000 divided by 5 which is 1400 meters per second. And the nozzle exit area AE equal to pi by 4 D square which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 7.85 10 power minus 3 meter square. The thrust produced is also given by F equal to mass of the propellant into CE. The CE is the exit velocity of the jet. This is plus AE into PE minus PA. So, the first part is the momentum thrust. So, the thrust produced due to the change in the velocity and this is pressure thrust. Thrust produced due to the change in the pressure. So, the pressure thrust equal to AE, area of the exit nozzle, PE, delta P across the nozzle, PE minus PA. So, substituting F equal to 7000 equal to 5 into CE plus 7.85 in 10 power minus 3. Into 1.02 minus 1.013 in 10 power 5 to convert the bar into newtons per meter square. So, from this equation calculating the actual jet velocity CE equal to 1398.9 meters per second. The specific impulse IS equal to thrust divided by weight flow rate of the propellant. So, IS equal to F divided by WP. WP is the weight of the propellant. Which is F equal F divided by MP, mass of the propellant into acceleration due to gravity. So, 7000 divided by 5 into 9.81 equal to 142.71 seconds. And specific propellant consumption. So, SPC equal to WP by F. This is the reverse of the specific impulse. 1 by IS equal to 1 divided by 142.71 equal to 7 into 10 power minus 3 second to the power minus 1. So, the answer to the problem, effective jet velocity 1400 meters per second, actual jet velocity 1398.9 meters per second, specific impulse 142.71 seconds and specific propellant consumption 7 into 10 power minus 3 second to the power minus 1. Example number 2, a rocket has the following data, propellant flow rate is 5.2 kilograms per second, nozzle exit diameter 9 centimeter, nozzle exit pressure 1.02 bar, ambient pressure 1.013 bar. Thrust chamber pressure 722 bar, thrust produced 7.2 kN, determine the effective jet velocity, actual jet velocity, specific impulse and specific propellant consumption and this is from November 2014 question paper. So, it is very much similar, this problem is very much similar to the first problem with a slight modification in the data. So, mass of the propellant is 5.2 kilograms per second, diameter equal to 9 centimeter which is 0.09 meter. Exit pressure of the nozzle 1.02 bar, ambient pressure 1.013 bar, thrust to produce F equal to 7.2 kN. The effective jet velocity CJ equal to thrust divided by propellant flow rate, which is 7000 divided by 5.2 equal to 1384.6 meters per second. The nozzle exit area AE equal to pi by 4 d square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.09 square equal to 6.36 in 10 power minus 3 meter square. Then the thrust produced, it is given by F equal to MP into CE plus AE into PE minus PA. So, exit pressure of the nozzle, PA is the ambient pressure, AE is the exit area nozzle. Substituting 7200 equal to 5.2 into CE into 6.36 in 10 power minus 3 into 1.02 minus 1.013 into 10 power 5. So, from this equation, the actual jet velocity CE equal to 1383.8 meters per second. The specific impulse IS equal to thrust divided by weight flow rate of the propellant. So, IS equal to F divided by WP, which is F divided by MP into G. So, MP is the mass of the propellant into acceleration due to gravity. So, 7200 divided by 5.2 into 9.81 equal to 141.14 seconds. Then the specific propellant consumption SPC equal to WP by F, which is reciprocal of specific impulse 1 by IS, which is equal to 1 by 141.14 equal to 7.085 in 10 power minus 3 second to the power minus 1. So, the answer to the problem, effective jet velocity 1384.6 meters per second, actual jet velocity 1383.8 meters per second, specific impulse 141.14 seconds, specific propellant consumption 7.085 in 10 power minus 3 second to the power minus 1. Example number 3, the specific impulse of a rocket is 125 seconds and the flow rate of the propellant is 44 kilograms per second. The nozzle throat area is 18 centimeter square and the pressure in the combustor is 25 bar. Determine the thrust coefficient, propellant flow coefficient, specific propellant consumption and characteristic velocity. And this is from May 2005 question paper. So, we are given IS, specific impulse, it is given as 125 seconds. The mass flow rate of the propellant 44 kilograms per second, throat area ASR equal to 18 centimeter square and the pressure of the combustor PO, stagnation pressure equal to 25 bar. So, we have thrust F equal to IS into WP. So, which is IS into mass of the propellant acceleration due to gravity. So, substituting 125 into 44 into 9.81 equal to 53,955 Newton. The thrust coefficient equal to thrust divided by PO into A star. So, PO is the stagnation pressure in the combustion chamber. A star is the area of the nozzle throat. So, substituting 53,955 divided by 25 into 10 power 5 into 18 into 10 power minus 4 equal to 11.99. Then the propellant flow coefficient CW equal to WP divided by the weight of the propellant divided by the PO into A star. So, 44 into 9.81 divided by 25 into 10 power 5 into 18 into 10 power minus 4 equal to 0.096. Then the specific propellant consumption SPC equal to WP by F, which is 1 by IS, the reciprocal of the specific impulse. So, 1 by 125 equal to 8 into 10 power minus 3 second to the power minus 1. The effective jet velocity CJ equal to IS into G, specific impulse into acceleration due to gravity, which is 125 into 9.81 equal to 1226.25 meters per second. The characteristic velocity V star equal to CJ by CF. CJ is the jet velocity, CF is the thrust coefficient. So, 1226.25 divided by 11.99 equal to 102.27 meters per second. The answer to the problem, thrust coefficient 11.99, propellant flow coefficient 0.096, specific propellant consumption 8 into 10 power minus 3 second to the power minus 1 and the characteristic velocity 102.27 meters per second. Example number 4, a rocket flies at 10,000 kilometers per hour with an effective exhaust jet velocity of 1400 meters per second and the propellant flow rate of 5 kilograms per second. Determine propulsion efficiency, propulsion power and engine power output. So, this is from November 2008 and May 2013 question paper. So, we write down the given data. The rocket speed U equal to 10,000 kilometers per hour, which is 2777.8 meters per second. Jet velocity CJ equal to 1400 meters per second and mass of the propellant equal to MP equal to 5 kilograms per second. Velocity ratio sigma equal to U by CJ, which is 2777.8 divided by 1400 equal to 1.98. So the propulsion efficiency equal to eta p equal to 2 sigma by 1 plus sigma square, which is 2 into 9.98 divided by 1 plus 1.98 square equal to 0.8084, which is 80.48%. And the thrust produced equal to F equal to MP into CJ. So MP is the mass of the propellant, CJ is the jet velocity. So 5 into 1400 equal to 7000 Newton. And the propulsive power equal to the thrust FP equal to F into U. So propulsive power equal to the thrust produced into the rocket speed U. So 7000 into 2777.8 equal to 19.44 into 10 power 6 watts. The engine output power EP equal to thrust power divided by the propulsion efficiency, which is 19.44 into 10 power 6 divided by 0.8048 equal to 21.46 into 10 power 6 watts. So the answer to the problem, propulsive efficiency is 80.48%, propulsive power, propulsion power is 19.44 megawatt, and the engine power output equal to 24.16 megawatt. Example number 5, a rocket flies at a speed of 10,080 kilometers per hour with an effective exhaust jet velocity of 1400 meters per second and the propellant flow rate of 5 kilograms per second. The heat of reaction of the propellant is 6500 kilojoules per kilogram. Determine propulsion efficiency, propulsive power, engine output, thermal efficiency and overall efficiency. So this is from May 2009 and November 2009 question paper. So we are given U equal to 10,080 kilometers per hour, which is 2,800 meters per second. CJ jet velocity CJ equal to 1,400 meters per second. Mass of the propellant equal to 5 kilograms per second. And heat of reaction QR equal to 6,500 kilojoules per kilogram. So we calculate the velocity ratio sigma equal to U by CJ. So 2,800 divided by 1,400 equal to 2. And we calculate the propulsion efficiency eta p equal to 2 sigma by 1 plus sigma square, which is 2 into 2 divided by 1 plus 2 square equal to 0.8, which is 80%. The thrust produced F equal to mass of the propellant into the jet velocity. So 5 into 1400 equal to 7000 Newton. And the propulsive power equal to FP equal to F, the thrust produced into the rocket speed. So 7000 into 2800 equal to 19.6 in 10 power 6 watts. So the engine power output EP equal to thrust power divided by the propulsion efficiency. So 19.6 into 10 power 6 divided by 0.8 equal to 24.5 into 10 power 6 watts. Thermal efficiency equal to engine power output divided by the heat released by the burning of the fuel. So engine power output equal to 24.5 into 10 power 6 divided by mass of the propellant into heat of reaction. So 5 into 6500 into 10 power 3. So this equal to 0.7538. So this is 75.38% thermal efficiency. Overall efficiency equal to thermal efficiency into propulsion efficiency. So propulsion efficiency is 0.8, thermal efficiency is 0.7538, so which is 0.603, which is 60.3%. So the answer to the problem, propulsion efficiency 80%, propulsion power 19.6 megawatt, engine power output 24.5 megawatt, thermal efficiency 75.38%. Overall efficiency 60.3%. Example number 6. A rocket has the following data. Combustion chamber pressure 36 bar. Combustion chamber temperature 3600 Kelvin. Oxidation flow rate 41 kilograms per second. Mixer ratio 5. And the ambient pressure is 585 newtons per meter square. Determine nozzle throat area, thrust coefficient, characteristic velocity and the exit velocity of the gases. Take gamma equal to 1.3 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So this is from November 2014 question paper. So we are given thrust chamber pressure TO equal to 36 bar, stagnation temperature TO equal to 3600 Kelvin, mass of the oxidizer is 41 kilograms per second, the mixer ratio mass of the oxidizer divided by the mass of the fuel equal to 5, exit pressure is 585 newtons per meter square, gamma equal to 1.3 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Mass of the propellant, MP equal to mass of the fuel plus mass of the oxidizer. So we take MOX outside, multiplied by MOX multiplied by MF divided by MOX plus 1, which is MOX equal to 41 into 1 by 5 plus 1 equal to 49.2 kilograms per second. The properties of gas at the throat. So we take the T star by TO, so which is 2 by gamma plus 1. So substituting gamma, T star by TO equal 2 by 1.3 plus 1 equal to 0.869. So the temperature at the throat section T star equal to 0.869 into 3600 equal to 3128.4 Kelvin. And similarly, pressure at the throat section, P star by PO equal to 2 by gamma plus 1 to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. So which is 2 by 1.3 plus 1 to the power 1.3 by 1.3 minus 1 equal to 0.542. The pressure at the throat section P star equal to 0.542 into 36 equal to 19.51 bar. The density of the gas in the throat section, rho star equal to P star by R into T star. So which is 19.1 into 100. 19.51 into 100 convert into kilonewtons per meter square divided by 0.8287 into 3128.4 equal to 2.17 kilogram per meter cube. So velocity at the throat section C star equal to square root of gamma R T star, which is square root of 1.3 into 287 into 3128.4 equal to 1080.37 meters per second. So throat area equal to A star equal to mass flow rate divided by rho star into C star equal to 49.2 divided by 2.17 into 1080.37 equal to 0.021 meter square. So the exit velocity of the gas in the nozzle is given by C square equal to 2 gamma by gamma plus 1 into RTO multiplied by 1 plus PE by PO to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So substituting the value 2 into square root of C equal to square root of 2 into 1.3 divided by 1.3 plus 1 into 287 into 3600 multiplied by 1 plus 585 divided by 36 into 10 power 5 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 equal to 2786.3 meters per second. The thrust produced F equal to mass of the propellant into Cj. So 49.2 into 2786.3 equal to 131.1 10 power 3 Newton. And the thrust coefficient Cf equal to thrust produced divided by the PO into A star, which is 137.1 into 10 power 3 divided by 36 into 10 power 5 into 0.021 equal to 1.81. The characteristic velocity V star equal to Cj by thrust coefficient, which is 2786.3 divided by 1.81 equal to 1539.4 meters per second. The answer to the problem, nozzle throat area 0.021 meter square, thrust equal to 137.1 kilonewton, thrust coefficient is 1.81, characteristic velocity is 1539.4 meters per second, and exit velocity of the gas equal to 2786.3 meters per second. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. So you can refer to the gas dynamics and jet propulsion book for additional problems in the rocket propulsion. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the gas dynamics and jet propulsion. Until then, bye-bye.